Good morning and welcome to Berks Heim at Work in the Community. My name is Ann Gilmer and I'm the Director of Volunteers. Today we're here to talk about Heimfest. And Heimfest is our big annual festival that's held every September, and it is sponsored by the Volunteer Service Board. So with me today, I have several members of the board, and we're all going to discuss different parts of the day so that you get a good idea of what Heimfest is all about. So to my far left is Erma Gerberich. Erma heads our volunteer quilters.
Good morning.
And next to her is Brenda Stein. Brenda is another Volunteer Service Board member and very active in helping us with other fundraising events, as well as some of our very successful bake sales we've had. And then next to me is Grace Reber. And Grace is also very active with the Volunteer Service Board and helps to get things prepared for the food items that are on the menus for the Heimfest. Heimfest is a fundraiser. It's the largest fundraiser of the year, and all proceeds do go to benefit our residents. So, but it's like a double good thing, because it's also like one of the favorite days for our residents. They all love and enjoy Heimfest because it really is a day filled with a lot of fun, music, food, and it's just a great way to gather and enjoy yourself. It's just a nice change of pace. So, Grace, let's start by talking about the menu. We really do have a nice assortment of foods and reasonably priced as well.
Good morning, everyone. And this morning I'll just tell you most of the items that we'll have for our fun day and our fest day. We'll, of course, have the regular hot dogs and hamburgers, and then we have a turkey barbecue, a very famous item.
Yes, and it is very popular.
And the farm women are in charge of preparing that. We'll have pizza for the day, and that's a special treat for our residents. We have sausage sandwiches. That's another item that's popular. We usually sell out of most of these items.
Okay.
Ice cream, strawberries, a shortcake or sponge cake with, you can have either way there, ice cream and strawberries or cake added to it.
Right.
We'll have plenty of cold drinks. And then we also have our bake stand, bake sale. That is a very, very good fundraiser for us because it's clear profit. We have the donations are given to us by a lot of our volunteer service people. The shoe fly pie comes from the Berks County Pomona Granges. And also we have a sweet potato pie, and that's also very popular. Come quickly.
Yes, it is.
Yes.
They go quickly.
They do.
Maddie Stevens and her Baptist, Zion Baptist Church donate those. And of course we'll have Sammy's French fries and funnel cakes.
That's
funnel
right,
cakes,
yes.
And, mm-hmm. and also... all we need is your presence there.
That's right.
To make it a success.
That's right. Very. And, you know, I do want to mention that the food items are really very reasonably priced. Just, you know, for example, the pizza is $1 a slice. Our sausage sandwich, I think, is the most expensive, and that's 2¼. You know, so things are very reasonably priced. And the French fries and funnel cake, we're happy that Sammy's is coming back out again. And they do give us some discounted prices, particularly for our residents. So we're glad to have them, because the French fries and funnel cakes, of course, are not typical food that you would normally get. So it's a nice treat. Yeah, and they have the cheese fries as well. So we're glad that they're coming out again. And in addition to the pies that are being donated, a lot of individuals, like you said, will donate assorted baked goods as well. And so they're, you know, of course, bake sales are usually pretty popular, and that one does well too.
The ice cream and strawberries.
Yes, yes, that's always
and
nice
shortcake
too.
Shortcake with
right,
that.
Right,
and
like
delicious
Grace,
too.
Right, and Grace had mentioned you can have it with ice cream, without, with strawberries, without, however
mix
you want.
And match.
Yeah, mix and match. True. Right, so that's another item as well. And we are fortunate and thankful to the Parks Department because they do set up two large tents for us at the front of our property, right aside of our main entrance. And Sammy Steaks, of course, is stationed outside. And so when you get food, whether it's from this stand outside or inside, you know, we have tables under these tents, and so you're able to sit outside and eat as well if you, you know, choose to do so. So that's always a nice feature that we have some inside and outside events. And we do have some games that are always popular with the residents and visitors. And if the weather's really nice, we'll put those outside. If not, then we keep them inside. So especially, and even if it'd be really hot, just because... even for the volunteers to be out there, then it becomes a little uncomfortable. So we're flexible to the last minute as to, you know, making little adjustments, but we do have the tents, and so they usually get pretty full with folks who want to sit outside for a while. So that's just another nice feature of it. And then, of course, something else that we're so fortunate to be able to provide, and it's so so much enjoyed by everyone, is our musical entertainment. And we have a lot of great entertainment again this year. And Brenda, you're going to talk to us a little bit about that.
Yes. The event is Saturday, September 9th, and it's on the grounds at Berks Heim. So... you can look for us there. It runs from 11 a.m. to 4 p.m. Wonderful entertainment. A lot of very talented local musicians. The main entertainment venues are held indoors in the auditorium on the first floor. The first group performing that day from 11 to 12:15 is Wendell and Rita Yoder. They do picking and grinning, which is a type of bluegrass music. From 12:30 to 1:30 is the Pretzel City Chorus. This is a local barbershop chorus singing music a cappella. Their variety of song selections is very enjoyable. Then there'll be a short break from 1:30 to 2 while the Swing Fever Band sets up. Then from 2 to 4 is the Swing Fever Dance Band performance. The Swing Fever Orchestra plays the classics, and that's my favorite music. Their variety includes music from the Glenn Miller Orchestra, which is the popular music from World War II era, including songs such as In the Mood, Moonlight Serenade, and Pennsylvania 65,000. The band features a female singer, Daryl Atkinson, who's very talented. Other artists' songs that they perform include Frank Sinatra and Bobby Darin. The swing band is quite the toe-tapping, hand-clapping, sing-along entertainment that most of the residents can relate to. They really enjoy it.
Yes.
There'll be other music venues during the day for residents who remain in their units. We have musicians Dave Reinwald, the Miller Brothers, Bob Hassler, and Wendell and Rita Yoder will again be performing on the units. Those venues take place in the unit day rooms up on their floor. So one other item that we will have in a room at the Heimfest is a flea market. And this is one big room full of treasures, attic treasures from people who cleaned out closets and what have you. A lot of the staff members donate items, and we, on the volunteer board, we have donated items, and they're sold very reasonable that day. Mm-hmm. So if you come looking for some goodies that day, I'm sure you'll find something to your liking. I want to encourage everyone, if you like musical entertainment, join us that afternoon. It runs 11 to 4 mm-hmm. on September 9th, and there's no charge to attend, but there's great food and music to enjoy.
And I'm glad you brought that up, Brenda. That's true. That, you know, all of this entertainment is free. There is
yes.
no cost. And I have to, really say thank you to all the entertainers because they all do this on a voluntary basis. So, this is like the seventh year, I think, that I'll be doing Heimfest, and it's still... It's just so amazing to me that the size and scope of the event and how so much goes on, and 95% of it is really done all by volunteers. We just couldn't have the event without volunteers, and that includes our musical entertainment. So we are always so very pleased that they continue to support us and really are a great entertainment for the day.
Right.
Yes, and so along with the musical entertainment and the food, of course, we have the flea market, like you talked about, and that is on the first floor and indoors the day of Heimfest from 11 until 3. So you have plenty of time to shop and look around, and we do sell things reasonably, of course, because it's a one-day event, so we don't want to have a lot of things left behind. But, we get a lot of nice donations.
Yes,
and we know that's a very popular event, and it's a great part of the fundraising. So
things can be used by the residents there.
Absolutely.
We get some blankets and things.
Right.
Or,
Right. We have residents who shop. We have staff who shop. And we have visitors and families who do as well. So that's always a really popular event. And as I had mentioned earlier, the Heimfest is a fundraising event. And so... One other aspect of raising funds is the raffle that we have, our Heimfest raffle. And every year we have a wonderful grand prize. And Irma's going to tell us about this year's raffle.
Well, first of all, I'm going to tell you about the volunteers that help quilt.
Yes.
We have a total of 9 volunteers that are quilting at this point, and one of them is a man.
That's right.
And it really works out very well. There's lots of joy and happiness with the group.
There is.
And but what we do is we work on quilts, and we work on big ones, and we do some small ones also. And I also have some wall hangings, which we are going to work on. Now, the big prize for the Heimfest is the queen size quilt, which you can see here to the back of the studio.
Mm-hmm.
And this is an applique quilt with a lot of quilting on it. It's called Heart of Rose. Some of those flowers don't really look like roses, but that's what they are meant to be. And
they
of course, you can see the heart in the center of the quilt. And it is a queen size quilt. We did quilting on it is hand quilted. It is not a machine quilted quilt. The tickets for this event, for the raffle, the tickets are $1 a piece or 3 for $5.
Well, they're $2 a piece.
$2
a piece.
Yes, or 3 for $5.
Sorry about that.
That's okay. We changed it.
Okay. We do have a bench that one of the volunteer service board members made. We have a $25 gift card. There's a baby quilt. There's afghan. There's a gift bag. And numerous leather items, which not all of them have come in yet, but
I'm hoping about 20 at least.
There will
in
be
all,
about
I'm
20
sure that,
items
that,
all together,
including some other gift cards and some
right.
We have a nice assortment of prizes every year.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And tickets are available the day of Heimfest as well, correct?
Right. Mm-hmm. Tickets are available today. Right.
They're available now through the day of Heimfest.
And they're at the at the main desk. Mm-hmm. If you walk into Berks Heim, you will be able to find some right there.
That's right.
And of course, they'll be available the day of the Heimfest.
Right. And they're actually available almost up to within a few minutes of the drawing time, which is 3:00.
Right. They're available the whole time mm-hmm. until we do the drawing.
Right. And you don't have to be present to win, which is important, too. So,
right, on any of the prizes, you don't have to be
present. As long as we have your phone number, you're okay.
That's right. We'll contact you if need be.
Yeah.
Right, exactly. Yeah, so that is, of course, very... It's just wonderful, like you said, that these quilters are in pretty much on a weekly basis.
Yeah.
With the exception of a few holidays or something. But otherwise, they are in... For weekly on Fridays, and like you said, right now, for a while, well, I don't know, for the last year maybe, the group has really grown.
Yes,
and,
it has.
And the camaraderie is wonderful between the quilters, and the workmanship is just beautiful.
Now, they're all volunteers. None of the residents do the quilting.
No.
It's all volunteer quilters from the community, from the Heim.
Several years ago, one of my sales was the top winner.
Yeah, that's right.
Only one ticket.
It only takes one ticket.
That's right. And it is interesting to say that we do have residents that will stop in to see the quilters and see what's going on. They enjoy it. They admire the work. Some have quilted in the past. And we also have staff that will stop in, too, or people will ask me, well, when are the quilters here? I'd like to see, you know, what they're doing.
Yeah.
So, and last year, I believe it was last year's winner of the grand prize, the quilt, he made it a point that he wanted to come in, and he wanted to meet the quilters and talk to them, remember?
Yeah.
And to see what it was all about, what you were doing. And he was very appreciative and just wanted to see
we're
it.
We're always, always welcome to have visitors.
That's right. That's right, yes. And be able to show your work, which is, you know, beautiful. So, like I said, this is the largest event of the year for fundraising, but it's also a great day. And I want to also say that we have great support from our staff, those who are scheduled to work that day and do their work in addition to assisting, you know, residents with getting to Heimfest and so on. And also our dietary staff and our EVS staff all do a great job in helping to have the rooms ready and set up, to have the food ready for us, and activities who help with on the units with the residents to make sure that everybody who wants to get to a certain spot gets there and works with the volunteers as a team to take people. They will know where a particular resident wants to go, and they'll let the volunteer know, and the volunteer will get them there. So it's really pretty well organized, I would say, and just a very special day, like I mentioned. We have a volunteer named Rufus the Clown, who even comes in, and he'll do balloon animals and entertain residents and children, you know. So there's just a lot of fun aspects to the day. So we are looking forward to it.
In addition, we invite all the families for
the residents
to come.
Absolutely.
You know, their extended families, grandchildren, great-grandchildren, because it is a fun day for them. There's activities for them to participate
in,
too. And
there is overflow parking.
Yes, there is.
If the lot is full at the Heim, we can park over at the Ag Center.
That's correct, yes.
And do you have shuttle service?
Yes, and we will have shuttle service that will get you from that area back over to Berks Heim, yes.
Okay.
And that same is true. Some volunteers have to park a ways away, and we'll bring them over as well.
Okay.
So that's an important point. Yeah, so there's no charge for parking, and we do have shuttle service if the parking spreads out a little bit. And I lost my train of thought. I wanted to mention something else about...
I think people could bring their lawn chairs, too, if
they wanted to sit outside.
Sit outside.
Yeah.
There's shaded areas there, too, you know,
right,
where the building
Yes, oh, we have a very nice campus with trees and things like that. So
gazebos.
Yes, right. The gazebos. That's true. Yeah, it's a very nice area to spend some time. So we and do invite, you know, the public is also, you know, if you've never been to Berks Heim, you want to see our facility, the property, what it looks like, find out where we are and that type of thing. You're welcome to come, enjoy some food, enjoy some music, and see where we are and how the building is. You know, we're very proud of our facility and always happy to have people stop by and see Berks Heim. So a reminder again, the date for Heimfest is on Saturday, September 9th, and it runs from 11 until 4, with the music starting at 11 and pretty much going all the way through the day, with Swing Fever ending at 4 o'clock. And then food is available from 11 o'clock on as well. And we will have, like I said, the games, the flea market, the bake sale. All those things will be going on. Tickets will still be being sold. And we really do hope to see you there because it is a fun day and it's a great cause, a wonderful, you know, we do it for our residents, for the fundraising aspect and for their enjoyment as well. I know people always look forward to Heimfest. The residents will always be asking around this kind of time, okay, oh, I need a volunteer to help me. I want to go to the flea market first thing. Mm-hmm. And I'll make a note of that. Okay, I'll make sure that someone's there for you. Or they want to get down to see the music right in the beginning or whatever they decide that they'd like to do. And then I believe you touched on this, Brenda, when you said with the music being on the units, we, you know, try to have all the aspects that we can of Heimfest throughout the building. And so having the music on the units is for folks who maybe can't come down or some may choose not to. And that's true also with our volunteers who do such a wonderful job. We actually give, the residents can actually make like a food order, you know, whether if they need staff to help, they will, or they can do it themselves. Mm-hmm. And volunteers will take those orders and get the food and then take the food to the residents. So we try and make sure that everybody who wants to participate or enjoy different aspects of the day has that opportunity. And, you know, I do want to thank the Volunteer Service Board for all their work and getting things prepared. And for your continued support. I know it's a day that we all look forward to. It's a very busy day.
Yes, it is.
We all go home a little bit dragging from exhaustion, to put it.
And Dietary does a wonderful.
They certainly do.
Wonderful
yes, they
job.
Do. That's what I'm saying. The staff and EVS gets everything set up and cleans everything up later. So the staff does a wonderful job as well. So we, between everyone, staff and volunteers, it really is a super day, and we do look forward to it. And if you are in the area, you are certainly welcome to come by. Again, that date is Saturday, September 9th, and it will be from 11 until 4.
And no rain.
Right. But even if it does rain, even if it does, we do
We still have it.
We have provisions
indoors
for that,
then,
yes.
So we do. But yes, we hope for a nice day, of course. Yes. Mm-hmm. And so, ladies, I want to thank you all.
Are they bringing the tractors again?
Oh, yes, we are going to have a tractor display, too. Thank you, Erma.
Oh, my goodness.
Yes, yes. We are very fortunate that we'll have several tractors that will be displayed. And there again, now, if it be a real rainy day, he wouldn't bring them. But if the weather is cooperating enough, Bob...
Sadison.
Yeah, that name's the moment. Yeah. Is very nice and finds a few folks who are also willing to let their tractors come and be viewed. The residents enjoy that. Some get their pictures taken with that. Mm-hmm. Speaking of which, we have a wonderful gentleman also who is our volunteer photographer, and he'll get a lot of nice pictures of the day itself, families sharing it together, and it'll be a nice event.
Wonderful.
Yes. So, ladies, I want to say goodbye. Erma, Brenda,
and Grace. Hope to see you, everyone.
Okay. Right. We'll see you there.
Thank you. Thank you. Good night.